club isn't the best place to find a lover, so the bar is where I go. Me and my friends at the table doing shots.
Hey guys, what's up? It is Sydney and welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, I'm really excited to share with you guys 15 of my personal favorite hairstyles. I like these because they are super fast, super easy, especially for school mornings when you're running out the door. Let's just go ahead and get started.
Okay, so I always start out with dry shampoo. If you guys haven't watched my videos before, I just really like this because I usually like to do my hairstyles when I have second day hair just because it helps the hairstyles to hold better. I'm starting out with a small section in the front of my hair and twisting this backward to create a French twist. So I'm incorporating hair just from the front of my head and not the back, and then I'm just pinning it with a bobby pin. You could totally wear this by itself, which is what I do a lot of the time, but I thought I would show another hairstyle with it. So I'm just taking the rest of my hair and putting it into a braid. After I tied off with an elastic, I really like to go back and mess it up a little bit, but that is just my personal preference. I like the messier look, so I will kind of pull apart the braid and stuff like that. So you can definitely personalize it in that aspect, but I love this hairstyle. A lot of you have been asking how I wear this next hairstyle since I wear it in a lot of my videos. So all I do is I take half of my hair and put it up in a little ponytail. I like to use a comb because it helps to flatten out all the bumps and stuff like that. And I also like to kind of put it high up on my head. Okay, and then I'm taking the ponytail and teasing it a lot. This will add a ton of volume. And then I'm wrapping it around itself to create a bun. And I'm throwing in another elastic, and I never get this perfect the first time, so don't worry. I just kind of tossle it around a little bit and add some bobby pins. And that is it for this hairstyle. Now it is time for what I like to call the Miley buns. So basically these are kind of like the Miley Cyrus buns, but I just kind of like recreate them. So I'm just doing two super high pigtails, and I do have a middle part. You could do a side part if you wanted. And I just put these up really, really high on my head. I like to put them as close to my part line as possible. And after I look like a crazy little girl, I am twisting the hair, kind of like I did for the last bun, and I'm just twisting the hair around itself and putting on a hair tie over top. And I'm just teasing the other one and doing the same thing. So I twist it around itself and tie it off with another hair elastic. And I always like to go back and add some bobby pins, of course, because it never looks perfect the first time. And that is it. So I know these are a little bit crazy, but I think that they are super fun and really different. Starting off with a slight side part, I am taking a small section at the front of my hairline, and I'm taking that and dividing that into three pieces, and I'm doing a very basic Dutch braid, except for I'm only incorporating hair from the front of my hairline and not like the back of it. In simpler terms for all of you non-braiders, I am just incorporating hair into each front strand and not the back, and then I'm going ahead and pancaking that to make it extra big. My number one braiding secret would just be to pancake your braids. It makes the world of difference. You guys definitely need to try it. So you could totally wear it alone like that, which is what I really like to do most of the time. Or you could go ahead and put your hair in a low ponytail and just take that excess braid and wrap it around the ponytail binder. This will help to hide the binder and also make it look extra beautiful and fun and different. So that's it for this hairstyle. I think it's really cute and really unique. I don't see it worn too often, so you guys should definitely be the first to try it. In Paris. To get away from your parents, and I thought, wow, if I could. So now on to the classic Dutch braids. I'm going ahead and dividing my hair on kind of like a side part. Honestly, I don't even know what the heck I was doing with my part. It's like half a side part. I don't know. But I'm just doing a basic Dutch braid, so I'm incorporating hair from both sides of my head this time. So with each strand, I add hair from each part of my head, and I just go all the way down until I reach my ear. And when I have no hair left, I'm going on the other side and just doing the same thing. To get away from your parents, you look so proud. Standing there with a frown and a cigarette, posting pictures of yourself on the internet, out on the terrace. And I actually kind of consider this a hairstyle in itself because I think it's really cute. I don't see it worn often, kind of like I said with the other one, but I think it's really cute, to be honest. But if you did want to go with the more classic, typical French braid route, you could just braid the rest of your hair and then tie it off with an elastic, and of course, go ahead and pancake your braid. Together, we'll get away with everything. Let's show them we are better. Let's show them we are. Show them. But that is it for these classic French braids. On to the next hairstyle. So I'm taking a small section at the front of my hairline and doing a typical Dutch braid, just kind of like I've shown you guys in my previous hairstyles. So I'm adding in hair from both sides of my head, and I'm stopping at my ear and just finishing off with a normal braid. So after I pancake it, that is pretty much it. I think it's really, really cute like that, or you could do another one on the other side of your head. So just the same thing, a typical Dutch braid and then a normal braid to finish it off. And then you can cross these behind your head and add some bobby pins to each side. And then with the extra tails that you see sticking out, you can just tuck them in with some bobby pins. But that's it for this hairstyle. So it actually looks kind of hard, but it really isn't, as you guys saw. So definitely try this out if you want to go ahead and fool some of your friends, because it's actually really easy. So for this next hairstyle, you're going to want to do a super deep side part, kind of around the arc of your eyebrow, and take a section at the front of your hair a little bit bigger than normal. So just separate this into three sections and do a normal Dutch braid, except with each strand you're gonna add a lot of hair. So I'm adding in hair from both sides, but I like to take the hair from the complete opposite side of my head and add that into each strand as well. So it's gonna end up being one really huge, massive braid. So I'm just finishing this off with a normal typical three strand braid and then pancaking it like crazy. Especially with this hairstyle, I recommend that you guys pancake it because it can be super big. And this one honestly does not take much time at all, especially if you practice it a lot, it will become super quick and easy. If you're not a braid person, do not worry, because these next few hairstyles will save the day. So I'm starting out by flipping my head over and taking a comb and just brushing this through my hair to eliminate any bumps. And then I'm doing a super, super high ponytail. I love high ponytails. They are my favorite kind of ponytails. And to add a little bit of pizzazz to my ponies, I really like to just tease it. This will add a more messy look if you are into that like I am. And then I also like to add a little bobby pin at the base just to give it a little bit of extra volume. But if you don't like this and you would rather do a classic messy bun, then you can just take this hair and wrap it around itself and put a binder on top. Super easy, super fast, and super cute. But if you're into the more classic elegant looks, I really like this one because it is super sleek. So you just take off your hair and put it in a super low ponytail, kind of on the side of your head, and then just wrap the hair around itself and put in another binder. And if you want, you can add a few bobby pins, but I love this one because it looks super elegant and super sleek, so I recommend that you guys try these hairstyles out if you're in a super big time crunch.
So that is all for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Give it a thumbs up if you guys want more hairstyle videos from me, and also leave any comments that you guys have down below. I try to reply to all of your comments. But I hope that you guys enjoyed watching the video, and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye guys!
You were staying in Paris to get away from your parents, and I thought, wow, if I could take this